The Isingiro District Environment Officer noted that the high influx of refugees from the neighboring countries of Burundi, Rwanda, DR Congo, South Sudan, Somalia, and Eritrea has contributed to the population pressure in the region of Lake Nachi Valley. Refugees and host communities have turned to the shoreline for cultivation and grazing animals. This has left the lake shoreline severely degraded in terms of vegetation.
Then the people are forced to go to the lake shoreline looking for water to cultivate their crops. But again, the crops they are cultivating them in the buffer zone, which is illegal. And most of them, they are planting vegetables, which they are using chemicals to spray against pests and diseases. And these chemicals are later washed into the lake once it rains, and which also contaminates or lowers the water quality.
Isingiro predominantly has pastoralists rearing many animals, and the district has also many crop farmers. With the influx of the refugees, there is shortage of land, and which has forced people to encroach on the lake shoreline. According to Onesmus Oreba, they aim to restore 14 kilometers of the lake.
Nachi Valley, a wetland system, and it harbors endangered species of plants and animals, whereby we have the yellow papyrus, we have the impala fish, we have the crested cranes, and these are species that are endangered to extinction once there is degradation, and you cannot find them elsewhere. So that's why you have to put much effort, much focus there to ensure that this lake is restored.
He called on the communities in the district to adopt the new technologies like modern cooking stoves, which are energy saving and use less firewood.
The plan is to ensure that we sensitize the communities to adopt these new technologies, because they are one, they are energy saving, they use less fuel in the form of charcoal and firewood, then they are also smart, or they are clean, because now Uganda is promoting cleaner production. And one who is promoting cleaner production to ensure that we have cleaner cooking methods.
The problem is also an outcry of the community, because it is the chief source of water for domestic purposes. Those using support from Dr. Deep and guidance from the district have embarked on restoration of the lake by planting trees around the lake shores. This testified to have benefited a lot through the project. We started this project after getting support from Dr. Deep, and we planted trees. The group is made up of 154 members, and they save money and have ventured into goat rearing project. We are in a group of 46 members in a briquette making project. We engage in this community to protect the environment. We don't regret. This project has helped us to earn a living. As refugees, we have benefited a lot from Dr. Deep tree planting project. The money we have been getting, we saved it and have managed to start a goat rearing project. We encourage other people to support environment protection project. Report by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.